keyframed video effects like pan and zoom, auto white balance, built-in audio effects.
Hello.
Green screen effects. That's my backyard. User-defined text animations. Get out of here. If you're looking to find a video software bundle that includes a video editor, video converter, screen recorder, and more, all in a user-friendly interface that has virtually no lag even on an older computer, stick around. I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
Let me show you what the Movavi software looks like. When you click on Movavi Video Suite, you'll get a user interface that allows you to choose the software you want to use. Let me show you a couple of these. First, let's open the video editor. Let's choose to create a new project, and you'll see it has a very familiar three-panel layout with our import and video tools in the upper left, our preview window in the upper right, and our timeline window down below. Let's grab a piece of video footage, and Movavi will drop that right into our timeline. Down at the bottom, you'll notice Movavi is optimizing my high-definition clips so that they'll play smoothly as I work with them. This is the very feature that will allow Movavi to work without any lag on your computer. It does this really well. Video editing software typically takes up a lot of processing capabilities, but I edited this video on a very basic computer and Movavi worked flawlessly. You can also import other types of files, and in this case, I've recorded my audio separately through a better microphone, so I'll import that as well. One thing I really like about Movavi is the audio waveform is dead on. So when I want to sync it up with my video track, I just expand the scale as wide as it will go in the lower left, and I can see a frame by frame view of my project. I'll just line up my microphone audio with the camera audio, and bam! Now it's perfectly in sync, and I can mute the audio that my camera recorded on the video track. Now here's a crazy cool feature. Once I start to edit these tracks, I want the audio from my microphone and the video to be sliced and diced all at once. So I click the little chain icon in the audio track, and it will link and lock those two tracks together. Now whatever happens to one, happens to the other. When I click on my video track, you'll see it opens up a whole list of options to tweak my video footage. I can make color adjustments, crop and rotate my footage, or use the animation feature to move my footage across the screen. I can stabilize shaky footage, highlight and conceal areas of the screen, use the chroma key feature for green screen applications, or even put my footage into slow motion, all of which I'll be covering in this video series. But this next feature is very cool. It's the pan and zoom. Now if I click that, I have three options. I can zoom in, zoom out, or I can pan, but check out how this works. Wherever my playhead is at, if I choose one of the zoom features and hit add, in the upper right preview window, it'll show me my starting point for the zoom and where it will zoom into. I can click on that screen and adjust my crop. I'll zoom into my backdrop and you'll see it will zoom in and stay there. On the timeline, it's actually added two keyframe spots, where the zoom starts and where the zoom ends. Stretching them out makes the zoom longer or slower and changes the location of where they start and end. Moving them closer makes the zoom faster. Now if I want to zoom back out from that point, all I do is put my playhead where I want the zoom out to start, click on the zoom out option in the upper left, and click add. It automatically recognizes where I'm zoomed into and lets me zoom back out in the very same way. If I click on either of the keyframe dots on the timeline, it changes the option to adjust those sizes up in the preview window. It's so simple and time-saving that this might be one of my favorite features so far. Now, if I click on my audio track, you'll see a host of audio options, including a 10-band equalizer, noise reduction for the tracks that have some background noise in them, beat detection that will drop markers in your timeline if you're editing to the beat of a certain song, and built-in audio effects. All you have to do is select the effect you want, and it will automatically add it to your audio track. I can actually access all of these functions just by right-clicking on my audio clip, and here you'll find you have even more options. You can add a marker point if there's a spot that you want to be able to find quickly later on, and you can add a keyframe volume point, which allows you to adjust the track volume right at that spot. You can add these anywhere along the track and control increases and decreases in the audio track instantly. You can even click right on the keyframe to remove it or even reset all of the volume points. If you want to add text to your video, check this out. Movavi lets you add titles, intros, speech bubbles, artistic overlays, but there is so much you can do even with a basic title. Let's select what we want to use and drag that down into our timeline. Some of our controls show up in the upper right preview window. We can change the font, we can change the font color, we can even add an outline to our text. We can change the opacity, and if we create something we might want to use again, we can even name and save our settings so that we can use it again later on. They'll be saved and listed in the upper left under My Titles. Now, if we right-click on the text in our timeline, we have the option to apply animation. This is where we can really make our text come to life. Just like our audio files, these effects will use keyframes that we can control. If we bring the snake animation down into the timeline, it will make our text move across the screen in sort of a slithering pattern. But with every one of these effects, you can actually click on each keyframe, and in the upper right preview window, you can decide where on the screen that text should be placed for that particular moment. Movavi will show you on the screen where the last position was to make your next choice really easy. You can move those wherever you want, and Movavi will move the text across the screen from one point to the other, following your exact directions. You can even stretch those keyframe points out across the text track and speed up or slow down how fast those animations happen. In the upper left, you can add another keyframe to wherever your playhead is located so that creating any sort of motion on the screen is as simple as drawing a roadmap of exactly where you want your text to go. Don't let Movavi's simple and easy to understand layout fool you. I've barely begun to show you what Movavi can actually do. Check out some of these amazing transition effects. Everything from warp transitions to pond ripples. There are even stickers and callouts that you can overlay into your project to make everything come to life. They have an entire effect store where you can pick up more amazing titles and effects to use in your video project. This is just the first of a five-part series where I'll show you how to step up your editing game with Movavi. You can download a free trial version right now, and Movavi was even cool enough to give us a 30% off discount if you decide Movavi is the right software for you. I'll put links to all of that down below, and we'll dig in even deeper next time. Peace. I thought I told you to get out of here.